Tom, retail owners always want to maintain an effective sales force. And it seems to do that, you really need to appraise the way they perform on some kind of ongoing basis. How does one best do that?
Well, I think the key is that there's ongoing basis, Dave. Too often I find, you know, we want to have semi-annual or annual performance reviews, things of that nature. That may work for some parts of an organization. I think that's largely ineffective when you're trying to coach and build up a sales staff because, you know, if you don't have pretty much instant feedback or quick feedback, you know, the moment's lost. The way you do it is the old saying, you know, management by walking around. But when you observe something done well, or if somebody turns in reports that are, you know, properly done and promptly done and so forth, you know, we need to make sure that we praise that. You know, we need to, you know, it sounds common sense, but you'd be amazed how many times all of us do something that we thought we did a good job, but nobody really ever said so. So do that and do that as public as possible. I mean, we don't have to do it over the PA. But, you know, if we're in a staff meeting or at the front counter or something, you say, you know, this really looks good. You did a nice job here. Way to go. If you have something maybe of a little more negative nature to talk about, we need to make sure we do that in somewhat private. You know, we don't want to do this, have the same setting and say, you know, in front of somebody's peers, you know, boy, you really screwed this one up. So I think, you know, the old saying, praise in public, you know, criticize in private. But criticize is a pretty strong word. You know, that's really not a word that most coaches would probably want to use. What I want to do, though, is focus on the act. For example, if you see somebody being maybe a little too negative in their conversation or the way they treat somebody, say, you know, let's review this. And how do you think that you could have stated this in a more positive fashion? And then make, because they may not even realize they said it. You know, so, and maybe they do. Maybe they're a negative person, in which case, you know, we got bigger work to do, or maybe they need to take their work and do it somewhere else, because that'll kill an organization. But, you know, on a coaching level, say, let's rephrase that, restate that. What did we say? What was our tone that maybe could be adjusted a little? And this whole conversation shouldn't take over a minute or two. Okay. We're not trying to stop anybody, you know, slow their day down. We're just trying to give them, you know, what do basketball coaches do? I mean, they're coaching every play. You know, they don't, you know, I know they have to wait till halftime to make major adjustments, but still, you know, they're not waiting to halftime to make that substitution. They're not waiting to halftime to cheer and say, way to go, do it again. Mm-hmm. You know, managers have to have much the same attitude within their staff.
How about an annual review or a semi-annual review based on the numbers, the production they put up, maybe their margin contribution? Is that a good idea?
Well, sure, it's a good idea. We have to keep score. You know, and it's amazing how many businesses I find don't keep score. You know, if you go bowling, you know, kind of want to know what your score was. If you play golf, you don't want to spend 4 hours and come into the clubhouse and say, well, I think that was okay. And yet, in reality, we really don't have those quotas and measurements among many of our staffs. So, yeah, we've got to have guidelines and goal lines, both intermediate and long term. You know, I always use the analogy of like running down a football field. You know, if they said, all right, you got to go 90 yards, and when you get there, you can score some points. Well, that sounds like a daunting task. But what they say is you got to go 10 yards, and you got 4 times to try it. And if you can do 10 yards, then you get 4 more chances to do 10 more yards, and it's just chugga-chugga-chugga down the field. And, you know, you can see from me to you. You can see 10 yards. It's kind of hard to see 90 sometimes. Well, you know, that's just a metaphor for maybe sales quotas and goals mm-hmm. we give people. You know, I want you to do 50,000 this week or this month, and that sounds like a pretty big pot. But if you break that down and say, you know, I want you to do 12,000 this week and 12,000 next week, and then in 2 weeks say, when you're 10% ahead of your goal or you're 6% behind your goal, and have these intermediate goals along mm-hmm. the way so that they can sense progress, because, you know, we can speed it up a little or you hope not slow it down, but, you know, you can gauge your process if you have intermediate goals mm-hmm. With a long-term objective in mind.
Is it a good idea to also set goals for techniques? Like you were mentioning, maybe you could do this a little bit more positively. Should there be goals in that regard as well?
You know, and it's kind of hard to quantify. Yeah, absolutely, that's the goal. And, you know, if we think we're going to really change somebody's personality, you know, we probably, you know, probably aren't. But what I want to do is just raise their awareness. I want them to know, you know, a guy that I worked with for years, you know, he'd say, "How you doing today?" And he'd go, "Oh, not too bad." He didn't even hear himself. You know, but that was just kind of a negative way of saying, okay.
Yeah.
Well, we can do better than that. You know, another man used to come in, "How you doing this morning?" "Tired." You know, well, that's a buzzkill, you know. So things like that are what you'd address and say, you know, people around here really don't all want to hear that every morning. You know, we're all tired. We all come in with our own personal cross to carry, you know. So let's, they're going to think better of you. We've got to always put it into the other person's mm-hmm. perspective. You don't really say, "I want to do this. I want you to do this because I want it." We need you to say, you know, "I need you to do this because it will reflect better to my customer." But you'll try it. You may like it. You'll find the attitude of others toward you and around you will improve. You might find you're not quite so tired at the end of the day if you don't have this negativity that's around you and that, you know, others are. You find others are either challenging you or in many cases walking away around you.
Is this a topic for a sales meeting? I don't mean single out any one person's performance, just talking about positive attitude in general.
Sure. And ask someone, you know, when I may take a product and say, "Sell this to me." You know, I talk about that all the time. You know, we might pass that around a table to 2, 3, 4 people and say, "I got free lunch today to anybody that can make the most positive presentation regarding the attributes of this floor and why you'd enjoy it in your home." Not just the floor, but the why you'd enjoy it in your home is what I'm really looking for. And then let them vote. But, you know, let's reward positive and let them think positive for a few minutes. Man, I'll buy somebody a sandwich every day for you know, just for that better attitude.
So that's something you would bring up and really reinforce whenever you can on an ongoing basis.
Every day. You know, it's the culture of the business. And again, before long, we all have businesses that we just dread going in the door, and we have businesses that we can't wait to get there. You know, we like to go there. It's enjoyable. My guess is it's got a whole lot more to do with the attitude and the culture of the store itself than it does the product or service they're providing.